All right. So again, welcome in everybody to our weekly recap webinar. We like to do these here at the end of the week just to cover what we did on the option side, walk you guys through the trades that we took, walk you through what we're anticipating for next week. What are we looking at? I'm actually going to cover some trades here in detail so you guys know what we're going to plan on doing going into next week. I do think it's going to be a crucial week. I started to talk about this. Don't know if you guys heard it or not. So I'm just going to review it real quick. Next week is crucial because we're going into a very key earnings season. A lot of the big tech names over the next few weeks are going to release their earnings. We have been in a sideways move over the past week and a half. You can see here on SPY, we've had some very phenomenal movement in both directions going back into March. But over the past week and a half or so, we've taken a pause. We've had big movements intraday, but we haven't had a lot of follow through into day two, three, four. We've just kind of been stuck in this sideways pattern. It's what we like to call the coiled spring pattern. At some point, we're gonna break out of this range. It's gonna either break higher or lower. We just don't know when it's gonna happen, nor do we know in which direction it's gonna happen in. But when it does, there's going to be a really nice move that we can play. So how do we look at this? How do we predict whether it's gonna move higher or lower? We let price action dictate that for us. And here's what we're looking at. There's a couple of key technical levels above us and below us here that I'm looking at. Let's talk about the downside. First of all, we have found resistance this week right on top of the 50 period moving average. It's that dotted orange colored line there. Every time we've tested that level, it has held and we've sold off. If that happens again today, going into the weekend, I could very well see us with another leg to the downside. Very well could see us test the 20 period moving averages next week. Those are the green lines, both the simple and the exponential, between 273 and around 270. That's an area of support below us that we're going to be watching. Now, here's why I'm concerned with this market making another break to the upside. Number one, on this move to the upside, look what happened to volume. We talked about it last week in our session last Friday as well. The volume continues to contract here. There's still a lot of uncertainty out there. There's still a lot of people that are saying, okay, I'm going to cautiously get into the upside, but we're not seeing price action that's saying, get me in at any price point. We're not seeing a rush to get into this market. And volume, even though 100 million shares, historically speaking, is actually a good number, it's still a fraction of what we are seeing on the downside. Also, looking at the VIX is still above 38. We're still seeing the VIX at an elevated level. There's still fear out there. Normally, when you see this type of a rally off of the lows, you would see the VIX just get absolutely crushed. It's moved lower, but it's still elevated long-term. Because of that, I think it's going to be more difficult for this market to just plow its way higher. Fully understand that the Fed is pumping in a ton of money into the system. I understand that. Don't fight the Fed. Everybody's saying that. But from a technical perspective, I am looking for a break lower because of these areas of resistance that have contained us here on the upside. Because of the lower volume, I'm looking for things to roll back over. I'm not saying we're going to get back down to the lows, down around 218. I'm not saying that at all, but I think we do need a pause, a little bit of a pullback here before we get the next wave to the upside. Now, I mentioned next week, it is such an important week because of the earnings numbers that are out. One of the tools that I like to use is earningswhispers.com. I've got the site up here on the screen. I just use the free tools on the site, and all I'm looking for are the dates that these companies are going to release their earnings. If we take a look at Apple, you go up to the ticker box up at the top, you type in the symbol, and it'll tell you that Apple has earnings out on April 30th, so Thursday after the close next week. Facebook, earnings out next Wednesday after the close. You can see it right in the box there at the top. Amazon, next Thursday after the close. You think next Thursday is any important? I mean, you have Amazon and Apple the same day. That's going to be a huge day. The NASDAQ is such a big part of this market. The NASDAQ has really led the charge on this recovery off of the lows. The NASDAQ is very, very important if this market is going to hang in there, if it's going to move higher. What these companies say are their earnings numbers next week is going to be crucial. Now, we saw Netflix come out with earnings this week, and the numbers out of Netflix were phenomenal. They had a great quarter. which makes sense. Everybody's stuck at home watching movies, right? But the stock, after earnings, still sold off. And it turned into more of a sell the news type of an event. And that's what I could definitely see happening next week. I'm not saying Amazon and Apple and Facebook can't head higher, but they've already had phenomenal moves to the upside. There's been a lot of good news already priced in. I am cautious here going to the upside. If they have phenomenal earnings numbers, I still think it's going to be difficult for all of these to just plow their way to the upside. If you're going to trade through earnings next week, keep your position sizes very, very small. I prefer to sell premium, to sell credit spreads in earnings, especially this cycle. I want to have that time decay working in my favor. I want to have the volatility working in my favor. And when I say volatility, I'm talking about volatility contraction. And that's exactly what's going to happen after the earnings are out. Once the earnings are known, the volatility is going to move lower, which causes the options to get cheaper. The credit spreads benefit from that type of a move. Now, normally in previous cycles, I have avoided earnings and avoided holding positions through earnings. I typically will get flat, wait a day or two after the earnings are released before I do anything fresh and new. I take that approach to just let things settle back in. That way, I'm not basing my trading decisions off of an outlier move. The day of, the day after earnings, the volume is going to be through the roof. You're going to have a lot of big range intraday. I don't want to base my decisions off of that type of an event. This time around, I'm going to hold through earnings. I'm willing to hold positions through earnings. I'm just going to do so with smaller position size and taking a look at using credit spreads. That's going to be my approach going into next week. If you're a little cautious, if you're saying, I just don't know if I like the overnight risk out of earnings, that's fine. What I have done in the past is use the 7 calendar day cutoff. Once you start to get 7 calendar days to earnings, I don't open any new trades. Oftentimes, when you get a week out to earnings, you'll see chop kick in. You'll see a wait and see mode kicked in for a lot of people. Could certainly see that happening again. We're already starting to see that. We talked about how slow and choppy the market has been the last few days. We haven't really seen any type of follow through. There's just a lot of wait and see. Everybody knows that next week is so important for earnings, and we're seeing that wait and see mode kick in here. If you do have positions already on and you don't want to hold through earnings, use that Earnings Whispers website, find out what those earnings dates are, and then make sure you're out of the position the day before the earnings are out. That way you're not exposed to any type of overnight big move. They can make big moves, and names like Amazon, Apple, Facebook, they can make huge moves after an earnings number is released. But you get caught on the wrong side of that move and it can get painful quickly. So you just want to be cautious. It's just not the time to load the boat. And that's why I typically play it pretty safe through earnings season. Now let's really quickly, for those of you that have joined us the last couple of weeks for our Friday session, I just want to review a couple of our trades, let you know how we plan on managing these. So the first one, let's just start out with our trade from last week. In last week's video, we went to QQQ. We went to the NASDAQ ETF and we decided to sell a call spread. And we used, let me get the May monthly options open. We used the May 15 monthly options and we sold the 222 call spread. So let me switch the symbol from Amazon to QQQ. And I'll load up that spread down at the bottom. We can take a look at where it's currently being priced. So we sold the 220 call and we bought the 222 call at the same time. We put this trade on for 84 cents. That's what we collected last week. It's now trading for 68 cents mid price. The neat part about this trade, we took a look at that daily chart. Have we seen any type of big directional move here on the big index products? Let me go back over and take a look at a chart of QQQ. Over the past week or so, have we seen a big move? We haven't. We've just kind of been bouncing back and forth inside of this range. We have definitely favored the upside. What movement we have had has favored the upside. So we have been dead wrong on the directional move on this trade. We sold a call spread, which is ideally a bearish position. I want that stock to move lower. We have been dead wrong so far. We have not had a move to the downside. And this spread is still making money for us. Okay, we're up 16 cents or $16 per spread. Not a huge profit, but when you factor in that we have been dead wrong on direction and we're still making money, that's why I love to use credit spreads in so many situations. They're more forgiving trades. So what gives? How am I making money here if the move has been dead against us? We're making money from the time decay adding up. We're also making money from the volatility decreasing. When you use a credit spread, you give yourself five ways of making money on the position. It doesn't give you the home run profit potential that a long call or long put would, but it gives you more ways of making money. If I buy a long put here expecting QQQ to move to the downside, that's like holding a ticking time bomb. That move better happen quickly and it better happen in a big enough way, otherwise I'm not going to make money. So what do I do on this position? Okay, we've been dead wrong. So I'm going to continue to hold the trade. When you sell a credit spread, when you sell the 220, 222 call spread down here, we need price action to stay below 220. As long as it does, we continue to make money. The only concern kicks in if price action makes a big move above 220. I'm not expecting that to happen. The market is already overdone in the near term. Right, we're hitting some resistance levels. Price action is starting to stall out. So I'm going to continue to hold here. As long as price action stays below 220 over the next 21 days, we're going to continue to make money. Now, if we do get a big directional move to the downside next week, that would help us even faster. So if you do have this trade on from last week, we're just going to continue to hold it. There's nothing for us to do here. We'll continue to hold as is, and we'll reevaluate it here going into next week. Let's go back and take a look at EA. This is Electronic Arts. This trade was actually from a few weeks ago. It was also a short call spread. When I say short call spread, guys, I see some comments in there. When I say short call spread, all I'm talking about doing is selling one option and buying another option at a different strike price. And we're creating a risk-defined trade. So on EA, what we did a couple weeks ago, we went to the May 1st options, and we sold the 108, 110 call spread. So if I right click on the 108 call, go to sell and go to vertical. We sold the 108 call and we bought the 110 call at the same time. It created a neutral to bearish position. We wanted EA to stay below $108. The price of the stock is now up at 116. It's moved dead against us. What do we do at this point? Going into next week, we know next week is a big week with earnings. We know the NASDAQ is going to be very active. So what I'm willing to do is I'm willing to hold on this position till Wednesday of next week. If by Wednesday we don't see price action moving back down towards that 108 level, I would close out of the position. The most I can lose on this trade, we collected 72 cents on this trade. The most I can lose is $128 per spread. Regardless of what happens, if I am dead wrong on this position and it does not recover for us, I can't lose any more than that $128. So that's why I'm willing to hold longer. I know what my maximum loss is. Let's give it some time to see, do we get a directional move next week to the downside? If we do, we could potentially scratch the trade, maybe take a small profit or a small loss. So if you have this trade on, I'll continue to hold. If we don't get any type of selling come Wednesday of next week, I would go ahead and close out of the position. That's how I plan on handling EA. And then finally, before we get to the new trades for next week, so hang in there if you are not in any of these trades. I'm trying to go quickly through those so we can get to the new setups. But wanted to give a quick update on the silver trade. This was a long call position using the May monthly options. We came in and we bought the 13 calls. And we bought them for around $113 per contract on silver. It was a bullish position. The only way I make money is if silver moves to the upside. So far, it has. It hasn't been a huge move higher, but we are up money. Again, we bought it for $113. It's currently trading for $134-ish. So we got about a $20 profit per contract. I'm going to continue to hold here. Still bullish on silver. We still have 21 days left to expiration. I'm going to continue to hold into next week to see, do we get any type of a push to the upside? All right. So again, we'll review all of those trades next week. So I'd love to have you join us next week as well. That way you guys can hear how we plan on managing those trades going into next week. let's transition now and let's talk about some new trades going into next week. Let's start out with a chart of Dollar Tree. This is symbol DLTR. What you're looking at here on the screen is a 195-minute chart. It gives you two candles a day. So it speeds up the look and feel of the chart compared to the daily chart. The problem I have with the daily chart just moves too slow. The 195-minute speeds it up. It gives you two candles a day instead of one. Well, over on the right edge of the charts, you can see price action has started to roll over to the downside. And look at our sentiment indicator down at the bottom. It's the red and the green histogram down at the bottom. And notice how over the past week, we have seen it flip from green to red. When that happens, we go from bullish to bearish mode. The bearish sentiment is starting to take over. That on its own is not enough for us to put on a position. I have to wait for confirmation. And that confirmation comes a couple of different ways. The first thing that I want to have happen is I want price action to close below our red and blue moving average up top. All that simply is an 8-period exponential moving average with some custom color formatting. It colors it red if the trend is lower. It colors it blue if it's moving to the upside. So not only did we get the moving average to roll over, it went from blue to red, but we also saw price action close below the moving average. That gives me confirmation that bearish sentiment is firmly in place. I am looking for a move to the downside at that point. Now, the pink dots on the chart do represent our entry point. These four pink dots here, that represents the entry point. As soon as that level is touched, that's where we're looking to get into a new bearish position. With the bearish outlook, how do I take the trade? The easiest way to do it is to buy the long put, which is what we're going to take a look at here in just a moment. Could you use a vertical spread here? Could you use a credit spread like we just talked about on QQQ or EA? Sure, you could. But we're going to take a look at a long put here to start. So let's go over to the trade page. Go ahead and load up the May monthly options. I continue to trade a lot of the monthly cycles. And the reason for that, they tend to have better liquidity. You're going to have better volume, better open interest. That's going to make it easier for you to get in and out of trades. You'll notice that Dollar Tree does have weekly options in here. But when you load up the weekly options, look at the May 8th weekly options with 14 days left. There is not a lot of activity here, right? I mean, you barely have any volume on these today and very little open interest. That's going to make it difficult to trade those options. Not saying it can't be done. It's just going to be more difficult for you to get in and out of trades quickly and at good prices. Another issue with some of these stocks that have lower liquidity, look at the difference between the bid and ask prices. If I go to the 75 calls, I just clicked on that line there so you can see it highlighted in blue. The bid price is 210. The ask price is 430. There's a $2.20 difference between the bid and ask prices. When the liquidity dries up, the markets will widen out. The wider the markets, the more difficult it's going to be for you to get filled at a good price. So instead of trading the weeklies, let's go out to the monthlies. I mean, if you go out to the monthlies, we still don't have great liquidity, right? I mean, there's not a ton of action. You're not going to have the volume and open interest that you would have in a product like Apple or Facebook. But I have traded Dollar Tree. I have traded the monthly options. I have had no difficulty getting fills long-term. You just have to be picky on the price. If you take a look at the put options here on the right, you can see that we don't have $2 differences between the bid and ask prices. You've got 20 to 30 cents difference. That's much more reasonable when compared to the weeklies. All right, so with us sitting right on top of the entry point, the 75 puts are going to be the at-the-money puts. I like to get 1 to 2 strikes in the money from the entry point on the chart. I don't like to trade the cheap out-of-the-money options unless they're part of a credit spread. If I am buying an option, I definitely want to get slightly in the money. In doing so, I'm going to pay more for those options. They're going to be more expensive, but it gives me a higher quality position. So if I go up to the 76 puts, they're currently trading for around $3.50 mid-price. Okay, so if I go ahead and click on the ask price of the 76 puts, it's going to create an order down at the bottom. I can change the quantity of this order. Right now it's set to one contract. I can change it to 5, 10 contracts, whatever you want the position size to be. I can change the price. And by default, it's going to pop up my order at the full price, at the full 370 asking price. Ideally, I don't want to pay the full price. See how there's a 30 cent difference between the bid and ask prices there? Ideally, I would love to get filled on this trade at the mid price. I just take the difference between the bid and ask prices and I split it. So if I adjust the price down, there's a little handy price ladder down at the bottom where it'll tell you the mid price. The mid price is at 360. So if I change my order to 360 instead of 370, it doesn't seem like a big deal. But if I can get filled at 360 instead of 370, that saves myself 10 cents. That saves myself $10 per spread. I'm sorry, $10 per option. So if I put on 10 contracts, I save 10 cents. That's a huge savings long-term. So if I get filled at 360, it puts a bearish position on Dollar Tree. I make money as the stock moves to the downside. That's the only way I make money. Now, if I buy a put option, it's a time-sensitive trade. The moment I put that trade on, the time decay is hurting me. If volatility decreases, that also hurts me. So it's not a deal breaker. You just have to know that if you're going to buy a long put, you've got to have a pretty strong directional opinion that a move to the downside is coming. All right. So let me go ahead and, let's just put on two contracts here first, just to see if we can get filled. So let me go ahead and place this order at 360. And we did just get filled. There we go. So now you can see my position down at the bottom. I have 276 puts on with 21 days left expiration. And we'll continue to track that position. Now, where are my target and stop levels? What I do is I like to take my entry point. So in this case, we got filled at $3.60. My initial target always starts out at a double. I'm looking to double my money on this. So if I paid $3.60 on that trade, and again, when I say initial target, we can always adjust it, right? If market conditions change, we can always adjust. And I'll talk about that in more detail in just a second. So my initial target is going to be $7.20. My initial stop is going to be at $1.80. That would put my stop at a 50% stop level. So now once that position is on, I let it go. I don't sit there and stare at the charts all afternoon. There's no reason to. Me staring at the chart has no impact on whether this trade's going to work out for us or not. The market's going to do what it wants anyway. I'll come back in and check one more time before the market closes this afternoon just to see if something changes between now and then. But until that time, there's nothing for us to do. We'll continue to just manage the trade, let it go. Tim asking, what date are we entering in? It's the May 15 cycle. It's the monthly cycle with 21 days left to expiration. Right. So that is the first trade. I just put it on now. I'd put it on with a very small position. We can certainly add to it. I typically like to place a lot of my new trades in the afternoon hours, typically in the last hour of the day. The reason for that, it allows me to see if there's any head fakes. Do we have any false moves intraday? And it also allows me to take advantage of the bigger volume that kicks in typically at the end of the day. All right. So that is the first trade on Dollar Tree. Let's zoom back over and let's take a look at XLP. This is an ETF. This is an exchange traded fund that tracks the consumer staples. If we take a look down at the bottom, again, it's the same 195 minute chart. Doesn't matter if I'm looking at an individual stock or an ETF, we're looking at the same chart. I'm still taking a look at my sentiment indicator down at the bottom, and you'll notice that for the time being, we have seen that sentiment indicator flip from green to red. We have the bearish sentiment taking over on the downside. Now, remember, that's not enough for me to jump into a trade. I've got to wait for a few additional steps of confirmation. The first step is we've got the moving average up at the top, the 8-period EMA, the blue and the red line. I need that to flip lower as soon as it turns red. I need that. Perfect. Then I want price action to close below that AEMA. We've also got that as well. So we currently have a short setup there at 57.35. It's where the series of pink dots are setting up. Notice price action has not come down to hit that level yet. It is a valid setup, but I do not take the trade unless that entry point is hit at 57.35. All right. So that's what we're waiting for at this point. If we come in this afternoon, if we come in early Monday morning, if that level's hit at 57.35, that's my green light to put the position on. So we can go ahead and get this trade prepped. Just in case it does hit this afternoon or on Monday, I'll walk you through how to take the trade. So let's go back over to the trade page. We'll switch this from Dollar Tree to XLP. I'm still going to stick with the May monthly options. Again, you do have weekly cycles in here, but if you open those up, they're not going to have as good a liquidity. It's going to be way easier to trade the monthly options here. So if we do get down to that entry at 57.35, the 57 and a half puts at that point are going to be the at the money puts. That's the closest strike price that I can get to the entry price on our chart. I want to go slightly in the money from there. If I go one strike in the money, I'm looking at the 58 put. If I go two strikes in the money, I'm looking at the 58 and a half put. I like the 58 puts, and here's why. Take a look at the volume and open interest columns here. Notice how the 58 put has 12,600 contracts of open interest and 63 have traded today. The 58 and a half puts only have 32 contracts of open interest and 3 have traded today. The 58 puts are going to be easier for us to trade because they've got more activity. There's more volume, more open interest. So I like the 58 puts here. They're currently trading for between $1.25 and $1.30. You're talking about $125 per contract. But keep in mind, we have not triggered into this trade. I have to see price action on XLP get down to 57.35. I know it's tempting if you're saying, hey, it's a valid setup. Why not grab it now? I'm by my platform. I'm by the charts. Let's just go ahead and get the trade placed. Because if price action never hits that entry point, that trade setup could potentially cancel. If price action moves back higher above the moving average, right here, if we move back up above the moving average, that trade could potentially cancel. And then you're left you're in a position that you shouldn't be in. So you have to wait for that entry point to be hit. So for the moment, it is a valid trade. So if we get down to 57.35, and if it happens this afternoon or even on Monday, I would certainly be looking at buying the 58 puts. And again, they're pretty reasonable on the cost side there. I mean, you're talking about between $125 and $130 per contract. Right, so that is the key to have that system in place, to have that roadmap in place. That's the missing piece for so many people. And guys, I don't care if it's one of our systems or another system out there. Maybe you've created one on your own. You have to have a rule set in place that guides you. If you don't, you're gonna be left overreacting to every little move back and forth. You're gonna watch positions too closely. So you're gonna overmanage things. And I say this because it happened to me. That's exactly what I struggled with for years. So you've got to have that rule set in place. Once you do, it doesn't guarantee you're going to win on every trade, but it allows you to have a methodology in place that puts the numbers in your favor. That's the very key formula for success. If you can manage your risk, if you can keep the risk small, have a system that puts the numbers in your favor long-term, you are going to be so much better off than 99% of all the other traders out there. All right, so if you have any questions on Dollar Tree or XLP, let me know. Just a couple additional stocks to look at. So here's Amazon. I bring up Amazon because it has earnings out next week. And I mentioned earlier that I'd be willing to take positions through earnings. Amazon is a very expensive stock. It's a $2,400 stock. Very, very pricey, right? You try to take a look at buying shares of stock, or if you buy a long call or long put. Okay, it's very, very expensive. You buy an in the money put on Amazon, you potentially are talking $4,000 or $5,000, depending on what cycle you're in. So they're very, very expensive. I would rather sell a credit spread because we can do so for a fraction of the cost. And if I'm going to sell a credit spread, do I want to lean bullish or bearish here? I want to lean bearish, and here's why. Look at our second histogram down at the bottom. It's the red, yellow, and green histogram. Over the past couple of weeks, we went from red to yellow to green. What that indicates to me, it's taking a look at standard deviation channels. We're looking for overbought or oversold conditions. And when these green bars start to plot like they have here over the past couple of days again, it indicates that's that price is between a 2 and a 3 standard deviation move on the upside. It means we're at an overbought condition. Doesn't mean Amazon can't move higher from here. It just means it's not statistically probable. In all likelihood, you'll see a period of chop or even a reversal kick in. Look what's happened since those green bars started to plot a week ago. See how price action just basically moves straight sideways? That's a very typical pattern when you start to see these types of extremes hit. If you want to place a trade on Amazon in front of earnings, based on the current chart that I'm looking at, I would rather lean towards a neutral to bearish position. In other words, I would take a look at selling a call spread. I haven't done so yet. I'm going to hold off on this one into next week. I think we've got some time here before earnings are out. But if we don't see, any type of movement here over the next week into earnings, I would definitely be interested in selling a call spread going into earnings. Is it risky? Well, selling a call spread allows me to be in a risk-defined trade. So I can control my risk right there. So it allows me to potentially put on a trade in a very limited risk way. And what I may try to do next week is, instead of waiting until Friday to do our market recap video, I may jump on here midweek and we can talk about some of these in more detail going into earnings. Apple, pretty choppy. It's had a really nice move off of the lows, but we really haven't seen much over the past week and a half, 2 weeks. We've just kind of been stuck in a sideways range between, you know, 270 and 290. I know it seems like a wide range, but in this market, you know, $20 move on Apple can happen very, very quickly. So we'll revisit this one going into earnings next week as well. And then same goes for Facebook. They've all had nice moves up off of the lows, and I favor putting on neutral to bearish positions here going into next week. So I'll circle back. I'll make sure you check our Facebook page and our YouTube page next week. I'll try to jump on before these earnings are released, and we'll talk through in more detail what we could potentially do going into those earnings. All right, let me quick bring up some slides here. Because I mentioned at the start that we had a special offer for you here today. So everything that I talked about today, I know there were some questions from people asking how did I structure the trade? You know, there's terminology that's being used that you don't understand. The key to successful trading is to have the methodology in place that puts the numbers in your favor. So instead of you going through hours of training material and hours of educational courses, what we have done is we've taken all the tools that we showed you today, our custom indicators, the custom charts, the criteria that we use to identify these trades. Why did I use a long put in some cases and a short call spread in others? Why did I take that approach? Everything that we do is following our methodology. And we've combined the charts and the options tools into one program. It's what we're calling our 1-2 options trading for income knockout punch. So let's go ahead and talk through this. How would you like to start receiving these real-time trade alerts that can produce between 30 and 100% returns on each successful trade? Okay, these are trades that we send out to our customers each and every week. I've given you a glimpse of those trades the last few weeks here in our Friday sessions, just to walk you through how we place those trades, what we're looking for. We do that every single week, and we send out between 3 and 5 trades each week to all of our customers. Now, why options trading is superior? We've already talked about that today. Okay, we've talked about the controlled risk. We've talked about the amazing leverage that these options offer. We can trade names like Amazon, Apple, Dollar Tree, and we can do so for a fraction of the cost. We don't have to trade the cheap penny stocks. We don't have to go to the binary options. I want to be where the action's at. And I also want to make sure that I'm taking trades that give me high probabilities of success. Those credit spreads that we talked about earlier, they give us 5 ways of making money on the position. That takes a lot of pressure off, right? Needing to be perfectly right on every trade. If you buy a call or a put, I'm not saying that I don't like those positions. I will use those. We talked about one of those here today. Talked about that on Dollar Tree. We talked about it on XLP. But I want to be cautious when I use them. I want to make sure that I'm using strategies that give me the best odds of success given the current market conditions. So here's the simple formula. Simple strategy, easy to learn, fast to implement, low capital, and minimal time. What I'm talking about doing here today with our trade alerts, it takes 10 minutes a day or less. Most of our alerts require between $60 and $400 of capital per trade. This can be done regardless of account size. It can be done in a minimal amount of time. So for those of you that might be looking for another source of income, a lot of uncertainty out there with the economy shut down and with this virus continuing to wreak havoc in so many areas. This is a great way for you to generate a solid source of income in just a few minutes a day. Okay, when you do go back to work, okay, you can still stay active in the markets. I think the key that a lot of people are realizing now is, you know, going forward, once things open up, it's best to have multiple sources of income. That way, if you do have, you know, something pop up with one of those income sources, you've got other areas to generate that income. And this is a prime way to do it. So these trades, they can easily be set up ahead of time. That's the beauty here. Okay, again, 10 minutes a day or less. We send you all the exact trade details, the options that we're trading, the price range that we're looking to get filled at. So you have all the information that you need to take action. You know when we get into a trade, you know when we get out of a trade. You're always in the loop from start to finish on every position. Now, we typically separate these trades into two different programs. We have our NASDAQ Options Superstars program, which focuses strictly on the NASDAQ stocks. And we have our ETF service. We have our ETF Options Superstars, which focuses exclusively on the exchange traded funds. Both are very powerful approaches, powerful systems, but they focus on different markets. The NASDAQ tends to be more aggressive, shorter holding times. The ETF service tends to be a little bit more conservative. Things take a little bit longer to develop. Both are very great, but the power kicks in when you can use both of them at the same time. Get that diversification in the markets that we trade. Now, we send out the alerts three different ways. We send them out in the Netpicks app. We send them out in Slack, and Slack is a free program that you can put on any type of a computer or mobile device, very easy to use. And then we also will send them out through email. So you've got three different choices there for how to receive the alerts. All you have to simply do is place the trade, and you can use the broker of your choice to take those trades with. It does not matter to us. So here's what you're going to receive. It's the 1-2 knockout punch that we talked about earlier. We're going to combine both services, starting out with the NASDAQ Superstars program. This service is going to utilize the indicators that I showed you today, the histograms down at the bottom, the moving averages up top. We use these tools every day to scan a list of around 50 products that we look at on a regular basis. Out of that list, we come up and we send you between 3 and 5 trades each week. Here's some of the names that we trade. This is not the entire list, just to kind of give you a preview of what we do trade. A lot of very common names on here, names that you're probably familiar with. And the beauty is you can trade names like Apple, Amazon, Google, and you can do it with as little as a few hundred dollars. We can be where the action is at, even if you have a small account size. We also add the ETF Options Superstars program. So again, all the same indicators that we use to identify the trades. The difference here is we're just looking at the ETFs. Here's a list of the ETFs that we look at. The beauty here is that you can trade ETFs that track different sectors, different regions of the world. Okay, you can trade biotech, financial, energy, utilities, healthcare. There's a lot of different areas that you can go to get that diversification. The ETFs are some of my favorite markets. Everybody loves to trade the big NASDAQ names, and I do too. But the ETFs can be even more powerful at times because they're lower priced products. The options tend to be cheaper and they tend to be better trending type markets. They're not as volatile as some of the NASDAQ names. So I really love to trade these ETFs. So we will be using a mix of long calls and puts, debit spreads, and credit spreads. Using a mix will allow us to react to whatever the market is throwing our way. Okay, we're not going to lock into just long calls, long puts. We're not going to lock in strictly to vertical spreads. Using a mix allows us to take advantage of the flexibility that options offer. Every trade that we do take is a risk-defined trade, so we know what our maximum loss is right up front. You know, there's some concern at times when people hear about credit spreads, you get intimidated because you feel like you can lose more money than what's in your account. It's just not the case with a vertical spread. So again, we do send out the alerts to you each week through email, through Slack, and then also in our Netpicks app. Here's a quick screenshot of the app. So when we send out an alert, you'd have all of the details right there. So if you are not by your computer, most brokers these days also allow you to download an app. You can get the alert on your phone. You can place the trade on your phone in as little as 60 seconds. So very, very reasonable for most people. You don't have to be stuck in an office all day waiting for those alerts to come through. We also include a daily roadmap. The reason we do this is we want you to get some insight into how we're interpreting the markets. When I looked at that daily chart here earlier, I took a look at some of those support and resistance levels. That's analysis that I do on a daily basis. We send you out a roadmap with some of those stats, some of those numbers on a daily basis, so you can get a feel for what we're anticipating that day. You don't have to spend a ton of time reviewing it. We give it to you so you can stay up to speed with what we're seeing on our side without a huge time commitment. So we send that out here every morning. You can get it in Slack, and we also post it on our exclusive owner's website as well. So the beauty here, you have five ways of making money on some of these trades. The credit spreads, some of my favorite trade types. And unfortunately, they're just underutilized by so many retail traders. They're going to allow us to take advantage of the high percentage of winning trades. We're going to have a 2-to-1 reward to risk ratio on all of our long options. So we're setting ourselves up for success right there. And we can profit from all market conditions. I don't care if we get back into a never-ending bull market. I don't care if the market completely falls apart here in the months to come. There's something that we can do in all types of market conditions. That's why we love to trade options. For those of you that do want to take their trading to the next level, this is not required, but we include it as a bonus. We have our full options training on the owner's website. So for those of you that are saying, hey, I want to get started, I want to learn how to do this, but I also want to learn how to do it on my own. That way I'm not stuck relying on somebody else for trade setups each and every week. Well, we do walk you through how to trade options on a regular basis. So we have a series of videos and PDF documents on the owner's sites that you can access immediately and learn as you go. The best part about that is you're making money while you're in that learning process. So again, all powered by the custom indicators that I showed you earlier. We use those indicators all day, every day on our side to find the best setups. You also have access to our support team. So any questions that you have going forward, we can connect through email, through phone. You can connect through the Netpicks app. We are committed to making sure you are successful. So you'll have access to our full suite of tools and support. So what does it cost? What is it looking like? I mentioned that we do have a special offer for you. We're currently running a flash sale right now. So I want to walk you through that here at the moment. We have kicked around different price points in the past. We had talked about a monthly fee, $297 a month. We're not going to charge you anywhere close to that. The problem with that price point is for some of you with a smaller account size, it's going to be difficult to get the numbers to work. We want to make sure you have access to as much capital as possible to trade with. So there's a very similar issue if we charge an annual plan. You're talking about a $3,000 investment if you use an annual plan. Again, I don't want to charge you anywhere close to that, okay? Because I want you to have as much capital as possible to trade with. So what Mark came up with is a very special offer. We're going to offer you a 6-month rate. So a 6-month access to both services. Remember, they're both typically sold individually. We're going to combine them both into a 6-month membership for $797. You get all of the trades with the NASDAQ and the ETF service for the next 6 months. You're talking about a couple of winning trades. The program has paid for itself, and you get to focus on growing your account. Best part about it, this price will be going up to the normal rates again here next week, but you're going to be locked into this low rate. We're never going to raise it on you. You're going to be locked into that low price going forward for as long as you remain a member. So the normal pricing here is $1,297. Okay, you can get instant $500 savings here by taking advantage of the $797 offer. Okay, so we're trying to make it as reasonable as possible. We know there's a lot of uncertainty. We know some of you are out of work. We want to be sensitive to that, and we want to make sure that we get this in your hands for the cheapest price possible, allow you to focus on creating that reliable source of income. If you prefer a quarterly plan, we do have a quarterly plan as well, $447 for a quarter. Obviously, the 6-month plan, a better offer when you compare the price points. But if you do want to do a quarter instead of the 6 month plan, we can certainly help out with that. It's $447 a quarter. All right. So here's the link to get signed up. Netpicks.com/income. That'll take you to the signup page where you can have access to that $7.97 price. And I put it up on the screen here as well. So netpicks.com/income gives you access to all of the alerts, 3 to 5 trades each week with each service, access to the app, access to our private Slack channel, to our private owner site. It's all inclusive there for 6 months, $7.97. We do take it a step further. We do include a money back performance guarantee. The way that that works is if you don't see a 500% return on your investment in the 6 months, we would issue a full refund. So if you don't see $4,000 in profit over the next 6 months, we would issue a full refund. Okay. All you have to do is follow the trades. At the end of the 6 months, if you're not up that 500%, you just let us know. We want it to be fair. If we're not making you money, we don't expect you to pay us. So we're taking all of the uncertainty out of the equation here. Now, you'll also have access to our crash course that we just held. We just held a 2-day crash course where we go through all of our options training from start to finish. We start out with the basics. We get into some of the advanced option strategies. You'll have access to that recorded content. So you have the ability to get started and get that foundation in place here immediately. So the day one replay, day two replay, those will be available to you, not a problem. Just some quick testimonials from people that are using the system, using the program. Here's Roger. Big thanks to Roger for sending this in. He's already doubled his initial trading account, which is great. We'd love to hear that. It's the best investment that he's ever made. Great to hear. James, 17 wins out of the first 21 trades that he took. That's phenomenal. Again, we're not going to have winning trades in every trade, but we're going to certainly win more than we lose. And that's the formula for successful trading. Vasant, the last 4 weeks, here's his profit numbers utilizing the program. I mean, you can do some simple math here, guys. I mean, this adds up very, very quickly. We love to see that. So we've got lots of other testimonials to share. You can see some of these on the screen. We try to over-deliver, guys, on the results and the support. We are committed to making sure you are successful with your trading from day one. And here's some additional ones before we wrap up. So we love to hear from our traders. We're very committed to making sure that we're generating consistent profits for you regardless of what comes next in the market. So you are next. We'd love to have you join our team. So again, netpicks.com/income. That gives you access to the 6 month plan. The quarterly plan is netpicks.com/income3. If you have any questions, as always, feel free to contact me. I'd love to connect and work through any questions you might have. Our direct contact info here is up on the screen. Mike@netpicks.com is the email address. Feel free to reach out anytime. So let me go back to the comments here. Questions? So Justin, making the comment that a monthly plan would be better for him. Feel free to send me an email. Justin, more than willing to talk through some things with you on that so we can help you get started. We highly recommend you start with a $3,500 account to start with. You can start with less than that. The problem there is it just becomes way more difficult to control your risk if you do. So that $3,500 level is the typical minimum that we recommend for newer traders. The brokers that we recommend using either TD Ameritrade or Tastyworks. Both of them have very good platforms, very low commission rates. The key there is you want to have access to a margin account. We don't use the margin to trade with, but it is required in order to use the vertical spreads that we talked about here earlier. I get this question quite a bit too. What is the split between just buying outright call and put options to vertical spreads? It will depend on market conditions and it'll change as market conditions will change over time. I would say long-term, it's going to be, I would say around 60-40, 60% vertical spreads, 40% long calls, long puts. But again, that can change. It can fluctuate over time, just depending on what markets are doing. We're trading a lot of vertical spreads right now because of the volatility in this market. options are expensive. So the vertical spreads allow us to control the risk a lot easier. So then that could change. If we go into the summer months and we see markets continue to settle down a bit, we could certainly see that shift. We're trading more long calls and long puts at that point. All right, guys. So a big thank you for joining us today. I know we had some technical issues earlier. Really apologize for that. If you have any questions going forward, let me know. Otherwise, keep an eye on our Facebook page and YouTube next week, because I will be jumping back on and we'll take a look at how to handle some of those earnings numbers here next week. So I'm going to wrap up here for today. If you have any other questions, go ahead and type those in now. Otherwise, enjoy your weekend, everybody, and we'll talk to you guys here next week. Justin, I just saw your comment on the products that you're trading. Just be cautious with those. Not saying you can't trade those products. It's just, it's difficult. When you're using that type of leverage, it can be difficult to make money long-term. I'd almost rather have you wait, save up some additional funds so you can use some of these standard options. It's going to be a more reliable approach for you. Greg asking, how do I feel about a straddle for earnings? It just depends on what the market does here next week, early in the week. When I go into earnings season, if I'm going to trade through earnings, I typically like to use credit spreads. I like to sell premium and take advantage of the volatility contraction. What I would be banking on is the move being smaller than what the market was expecting. And I would be expecting volatility to decrease going through earnings. So that's my approach. Not opposed to buying options. It's very difficult. You just have to look at it as a long shot. When they work, it's great. You just have to know it's an all or nothing approach. You're going to have a big profit or a big loss. So you have to keep your risk in check there if you're going to buy options. So I would much rather use the credit spreads. That way we can be in a risk defined trade, still make a little bit of money, just do so in a much more conservative route. Do I use leaps? I personally do not. And I've talked about this in previous sessions here. The thought process there is when you start to go out months at a time, let's say we go out to the end of this year or early next year, a lot can happen, right? We've got this virus that is continuing to linger, and I don't see it going anywhere anytime soon. We've got an election cycle upcoming. There's a lot of unknowns. I think it's very, very difficult to predict what's going to happen in this market going out months at a time. It's much more reasonable to take a look at what the market's going to do over the next few days to the next few weeks. Our typical holding time is anywhere from 2 days and out to 3 weeks. That's our window. I think it's much more doable to predict what the market's going to do in the near term. When you start to go out that far, it's difficult, in my opinion. So I tend to trade the shorter term options. I typically trade options that have between 20 and 60 days left to expiration. Sell calls and puts on the leaps. Yeah, I mean, I'm not opposed to it. Okay, it's just not my style personally. Instead of using the leaps, I would much prefer to sell options and sell spreads that might have, 20 to 40 days left to expiration. Because now I can better react to the swings back and forth, and I can start to create more of an ongoing income source. Instead of just taking a trade that goes farther out in time with the leaps, I'm able to generate more active income in the near term. That's just what I have found more success doing. So if you're saying, hey, I don't mind taking a long-term position with the leaps, sure, it's perfectly fine. It's just not the approach that I take personally. Yeah, it certainly can be used as a stock replacement. That's fine. Yep. Don't have a problem. There's so many different ways that you can approach the options markets. That's why I love to trade them. There's just tremendous flexibility there. So And don't have an issue there at all. All right. So I think that's all the questions again, guys. If you have any other questions going forward, feel free to email me, mike@netpicks.com, and I'll be in touch right away. All right. Enjoy your weekend, everybody. We'll talk to you next week.